Hey, it's Jang here with my first fully custom Lego train mock. I call this the PM A12. P stands for passenger, M for medium duty, A for amalgamated, and 12 is actually the numbers 1 and 2, 1 representing the fact that it's my first custom passenger train, and 2 standing for the use of two cars in this electric multiple unit train, or EMU style train. This is, well, you could also just call this by its short name, which is happiness. For me, I've been working on this pretty continuously for 2 weeks now. I've had to add parts twice, I think. Two BrickLink orders went into this. A lot of experimentation, a lot of trial and error, many different things design-wise were tried, many different building techniques were tried to get to the point where it is right now. I'm not going to call it complete because I don't think any mock of mine is ever complete. I always end up going back and making improvements over time, or at least wanting to make improvements over time. And with the Lego system, the whole brick system, it's easy to do. So I think I will do that. This is, for me, it's a combination of three sets, or the looks and feels of three different official Lego trains. First off, you can see the Intercity Express, the white passenger train. Gives its nose canopies, both front and rear, or rear and front, whichever way you want to look at that. It's pretty much symmetrical. And then the most recent red passenger train from the City series, which contributes the primary kind of size and shape and idea of what type of train it would be. That train was a little bit too generic for me and was missing a lot of things, but I used a lot of its parts. But then also I used a lot of stuff from, or a decent amount of stuff from, the Horizon Express set, the TGV, the orange train, the 2013 Lego Club or online shop exclusive. So I've put all those together to create just this custom train. I'm going to go ahead and decouple these two. Actually, before I do that, let me just rotate it around a little bit so you can see what it looks like from some different angles. Got to zoom out a little bit. Really happy with the way that this has turned out, because it's gone through a lot of ups and downs as I've tried different things to try to figure out how to make this thing work on the whole. I'm actually really happy with the way that this connection point happened here, with just a fairly small gap, and I like the use of just that little slope. I was not expecting to do that. I don't think I've seen a train do it that way, but I'm just so happy with it. A lot of work and came out. Okay, we'll go ahead and decouple these and show you just one car at a time so I can zoom in more. And you can see a little bit more closely just what we're dealing with. So obviously the Horizon Express gave its exclusive orange train base, and I mean, you can see where the nose came from. I got the windows and also this part down here underneath from the red passenger train, the official one. A little bit of the design of this area here, the pantograph is also from it. But then with that said, I wanted to have transparent windows all the way through on both cars, which the original didn't, because it's RC and has the big old battery pack sitting right there, and then the infrared receiver is in the way. This is actually the unpowered car that you're looking at right now. All of these doors, the window part of these doors, comes from the Horizon Express also. But there you can see right through, and I've got a few passengers in there already, and I've got some bars, those vertical bars, handrails for holding on to when the train gets packed. A little bit of detail on the top. I actually want to replace these with these, just use the smooth ones, but I ran out of, I only had two of these, so I had to use the next best thing. And this one is playing the part of a forward cab right now, so there is a driver figure in there. He's got a door behind him, and he does have the console piece. Can't really see it here because it's dark inside, but he does have the console piece from the red passenger train that's right there, the printed slope piece. And unpowered trucks, we do have a little bit shorter one in the front, longer one in the back, similar to what's on the red passenger train. I did make this one just a little bit longer, but that was kind of necessary to fit in this size. I did need to use the longer truck for the rear portion in order to be symmetrical with the RC, the powered one, the power functions motor set for trains. And I also needed to have the ability for these to turn through their full range of motion, so I can go on short layouts with tight turns. But I think I pulled all that off with a new color scheme that I want to use for my passenger line, my inner city, intra and intercity commuter trains. I think I want to use this color scheme in general, with the orange and the white and a little bit of striation coming into it. It's really too bad about this gap right here, because that's just something that happens with the shape of this piece, of the canopy piece. There's just no way around that, at least that I've been able to see. But that takes care of the unpowered one. And then when you look at the powered one, this is really where most of my time went into. The unpowered one is pretty much just a copy of this minus the power functions pieces. But here, again, you turn it on the side and you still see through it, and you still see passengers in there. I'll turn this around, you can see on the other side. There's your passengers, one male, one female, and one weirdo. In this case, still got the doors. You can still see through, you still have the same number of actual seats in there, unlike with the red passenger train that I just was unsatisfied with. And the way I pulled that off, and you can see up here, also have open space here where you've got the seat, so it's pretty symmetrical. You've got the seat there, and again the console piece, the same console piece here as we had at the other end. But this one has the motor, the electric motor, down here. That's actually the powered one. The receiver, the infrared receiver for the RC system, is right here. And that's just made, you know, this one basically has a dummy version of the same thing. And then the receiver wiring goes underneath, forward, and then to the powered motor section. So it actually goes under here, then turns to come forward, so I don't have the wire sticking out the back. I needed room for the coupling. And then the battery box is here. So that's how I kind of cheated that in. I tried a bunch of things to try to hide the battery box underneath, but I just was not able to pull off quite what I wanted with enough structural integrity. So I fell back on just placing it in here, and still had enough room to have a pretty full passenger compartment and an actual driver's compartment. You can still put a driver in there, and it's only blocking the space of this window here, which is kind of for nothing. I haven't even figured out what to put into that section, because I moved my driver a little bit, I think a little bit farther forward than it normally would be on a train like this. But the end result, when you put them together, I'm using, you can see the wire sticking through here, but I am going to put the powered unit at the rear and this one at the front, just because this one looks a little bit better with the driver compartment. And I think that the physics of it will work out just a little bit better with this being the driven set of axles there. But there you go. That is my first custom train. Like I said, been working on this for a couple of weeks, tried so many different things, failed in so many different ways before finally coming up with something that works and that I'm really, really happy with. Can't wait to have a nice layout to actually put this on. Some future things that I'll most likely do include making these details a little bit more consistent and a little bit more sleek, and then adding the lights. I want to actually have working lights, and that's going to be tough to get the wiring past there without getting in the way of the interior and without letting those wires be visible from the outside. Oh yes, the wires from the main wire from the, this is, we're looking at, oh no, this is the front. This is the front, okay. The main wire from the battery box actually goes through the roof, and then the wire for going from the receiver to the motor, that goes through the floor. So we've got wiring all over the place. It's gonna be tough to get the headlight, taillight wires in there. I wanna at least get the headlight wires set up so I can have some working lights. I do have the lenses or the bezels in there with, or prisms actually, prisms, with the yellow ones up front and the red ones in the back. We'll see how that works out. Hopefully that'll work out okay. One things that I don't like about this one, like I said, the gap here, and also I was not able to get a simple, easy way to turn the whole system on and off. So you have to access the on-off switch right here. The on-off switch requires the removal of this piece, which is, it's just four studs that connect, or four lugs that connect the entire canopy piece. So it's really easy to do, that's unfortunate that I had to cover that up so I don't have an easy access, but it's okay. In all, I'm just, again, just really, really happy with this. Glad to have a train that's going to be in or on the layout that is mine and only mine, and has its own flavor and combines the things that I like about several sets together. So that's that. The PM A12 passenger train. Thank you very much for watching. One of these days when I actually have the space set up and tables and everything, and I actually am able to put the train tracks down, I will share more videos of this thing as it actually starts running around the layout. But for now, that's it. Talk to you again soon.